Brigham City, a small town in northern Utah, is home to a Mormon tabernacle and many meeting houses for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, also known as Mormons. Situated downtown on Main Street is a tiny storefront building where a small Christian church called Living Hope Christian Fellowship meets.
Many of the Christians that meet at Living Hope are former Mormons. And so when we're talking about Mormons, we're talking in many cases about spouses and children and grandchildren. We're talking about co-workers and people that we've known all our lives. So of course we love them. Of course we're for them.
The opening lines of the introduction to the Book of Mormon declare that the Book of Mormon is a volume of Holy Scripture comparable to the Bible.
Is the Book of Mormon comparable to the Bible? A very important question, and one that the Christians at Living Hope felt like we really needed to address. Scott and I interviewed archaeologists and anthropologists, geographers, linguists, on location and from a variety of different backgrounds.
In our interviews, we asked the same questions about both the Bible and the Book of Mormon. In all, we conducted nearly 40 interviews throughout the United States and in 6 different countries around the world.
And we were investigating one simple question: is the Book of Mormon comparable to the Bible? And this is the story of what we found.
Is my faith based upon something historical? It's a very important question to ask.
Is this something that I can believe in? Can I believe it physically? Can I believe that the text tells a true story of the past? But also, can I believe in it spiritually?
Well, I grew up with the belief that the Book of Mormon was literally the Word of God. So there was a distinction. The Bible was seen as corrupted. The Book of Mormon was seen to be much more directly from God.
The Book of Mormon is the Word of God and is the most correct book.
So you believe it's more correct than the Bible?
I do.
Most of the biblical account takes place in a small strip of land between the Mediterranean Sea and the Jordan River, and between the Sea of Galilee and the Dead Sea. To the south lies the Red Sea in Egypt. This land, originally known as Canaan, is where God established His chosen people, the Israelites. One of the earliest and most famous of the Israelite kings was David, who established the Kingdom of Israel. David's son Solomon succeeded him as king and built a temple for the Lord on Mount Moriah in Jerusalem. After Solomon died, the kingdom was divided in two. The northern kingdom was called Israel, and the southern kingdom was known as Judah. The Bible says the Assyrian Empire conquered the northern kingdom of Israel. The southern kingdom remained intact until 586 BC, at which time it was conquered by the Babylonian Empire, and its people were exiled after the Babylonians burned Jerusalem. And after 70 years of exile, a remnant of the people from Judah, known as Jews, were allowed to return to Jerusalem and rebuild the temple and the city walls. The New Testament opens with the lands of Israel and Judah, now called Palestine, under Roman rule. Herod was king and had added to the temple. The New Testament records the fulfillment of the Old Testament in the coming of the Messiah in the person of Jesus Christ. According to the Book of Mormon, a group of people known as the Jaredites migrated to the New World in the distant past, following the events surrounding the Tower of Babel. Centuries later, the Jaredites destroyed themselves in a massive civil war. It is said that 2 million people died in a single battle on a hill, which the Book of Mormon later identifies as the Hill Cumorah. As the Jaredites died out, a Jewish family from Jerusalem migrated to the Americas around 600 BC. The father of this family was named Lehi. From his righteous son Nephi grew a nation of white-skinned people called Nephites, while his rebellious sons Laman and Lemuel fathered the Lamanite nation, who were cursed with a dark skin for their rebelliousness. The two nations were in nearly constant conflict with one another. The culminating event of the Book of Mormon took place around AD 34, when Jesus Christ visited the Nephites and Lamanites living in the Americas following his death and resurrection. This event brought centuries of peace between the Nephites and the Lamanites. However, the peace did not last, and the Hill Cumorah once again became the setting for a massive slaughter. The Lamanites completely destroyed the Nephites down to one man named Moroni. 1,400 years later, Moroni appeared as an angel to the young Joseph Smith Jr., telling him that there was a book written upon gold plates and that it was an account of the former inhabitants of this continent. After Smith received the plates on the Hill Cumorah, he claimed to translate the ancient record into English. The Book of Mormon was published in Palmyra, New York in the year 1830. And from that time on, Joseph Smith and every LDS prophet and apostle after him has proclaimed it to be a true and accurate history of ancient America. This painting is a familiar piece of artwork to most Mormons and represents the Mormon teaching that while the Bible is a historical account of the Old World, the Book of Mormon is a historical account of the Americas.
We travel to upstate New York because the Hill Cumorah is there, which is central to Mormonism. It's the traditional site where the great battles described in the Book of Mormon were fought. It's owned by the Mormon Church. They have a statue of Moroni and a visitor center, and they put on a pageant during the summertime that retells the Book of Mormon story. In fact, it's the only place that the LDS Church declares to be an official ancient historical site.